Hi, this is Natalie Rice. We're here for sportsbookreview.com. Aston Villa hosts Sunderland on Saturday. Now, the Villans are faring slightly better than Sunderland, who haven't managed a win this season. Both will be playing for those much-needed 3 points. But what will the final outcome be? BMR contributor and sports writer Richard Prue is here now on the line to preview the match. And stay tuned for his top tip at the end. Now, Sunderland have failed to beat Aston Villa in their last 5 head-to-heads, and they've only managed to score in one of those matches. So what are you predicting to see on the pitch this Saturday?
Well, I don't expect it to be an exciting game, to be frank. Aston Villa have lost 2 of their first 3 games, are very much a team that's having to develop during the season because many of their new recruits came very late in pre-season. They won at Bournemouth and then, as I said, have lost 2 in a row. And Sunderland looked extremely poor at the start of the season and got their first point of the season at home to Swansea at the weekend. I think Aston Villa should be favourites here. Sunderland have gone at bookmakers to outright favourites for relegation at 8-13 or about 1.6, 1.7. And that's only after 3 games of the season. So that's showing you that there's very little confidence that the team will be competitive through the season. I think there's a possibility that the manager will change sooner rather than later as well. Mm-hmm. And they have to go to Aston Villa. This is Sunderland with 1 point in 3 games, with not many goals and a fairly leaky defence. So they're priced at 5 at BetVictor, and I don't think that's too attractive. I think the percentage play here has to be Aston Villa.
Aston Villa currently priced 1.91 Paddy Power, the draw 3.6, Bet 365, and then Sunderland 5 with BetVictor. Now, looking
Not a bet I'd have with any great confidence, because Aston Villa themselves aren't that prolific a scoring side. Uh-huh. But I think that's the side I have to be.
All right, so you're liking Aston Villa. Do you have any leans on sort of goals here? The under has the shorter odds, 1.75 BetVictor, and then both teams to score no also comes in low, 1.83 also BetVictor.
Well, it's no surprise that the market is telling you that this will be a low-scoring match that could be 1-0.
Okay.
A quote of 1.75 for over 2.5 goals is very low within any Premier League week. And to have both teams to score no as a favourite is unusual when you're looking at both matches. So the market is telling you that this will be 1-0 either way, possibly 2-0, something like that. It's basically telling you that it doubts that Sunderland will score, and it's basically telling you that Aston Villa won't score too many either. Mm-hmm. I think I'd be that way as well, but I don't think either 1.75 for under 2.5 goals or 1.83 for both teams to score no gives you a great deal of value. I think I'd just keep it simple and Aston Villa at 1.91 and expect them to be slightly the better team.
All right. And what about for those watching, if they were sort of considering Aston Villa winning 2-0, is that a bet that you would advise?
I think that's the most likely outcome.
Uh-huh.
I haven't got the price to hand of that, but that's going to be something around 2.5
I
look at it. I think that would be the most likely if you wanted something a bit more than 1.91 on the outright win. And then we can all watch, as it's a season of surprising results so far, Sunderland winning a 4-3 thriller.
Yeah, exactly.
But I'd be surprised.
Exactly. Hey, listen, anything can happen. Okay, was the tip here. Aston Villa to win 1.91 with power. That was Richard Prue, their sports writer and BMR contributor. Richard, thank you for joining us.
Thank you.